family get all dressed up. There's not a meaning behind it. Start to bat this devil down that's in the world. But see, we keep looking for red horns and tails and all this. These is people. Satan either was a man and passed it down to his generation, or got into a man and that spirit just keep coming on down the line. But like I keep saying, if you know your truth and don't change it, you think they're going to come clean and tell the truth that they lied? They're not going to do that. If you know your truth and don't change it, they not going to come forward and admit that they lied. But you knowing your truth proves that somebody lied. And it ain't God, because even the Bible says he's not a man he should lie, or a son of man he should repent. So who's it on? Is it on you, me? Because we've been taught this and was ignorant, didn't know no better. You know, because God say study to show yourself approved unto God. See, we let the pastor do the studying. Is he studying right? What they teaching you in college? They teaching you everything in seminary college to back up that Bible right there. And that Bible bringing, pushing people out, hooping, hollering, trying to catch the Holy Spirit, falling out in church. And they looking at you over there in Rome like, these damn people is crazy. Yeah, that's what they doing. They sitting around in round tables and bishop circles and all these other meetings there. And all the saints gathering, forsake not the assemblies of the saints, the Bible says, right? Also says something about the assemblies of the wicked ones. Well, could they be the same people? Your Bible says a lot. It says enough for you not to be oppressed anymore by anybody's religion other than the one God, Yahweh, Christ, Yeshua, and the Holy Spirit inspired for you. Yep. That's it. No way. Christ's name supposed to have Christians attached to it. Christianity attached. But they know words. I'm glad I like words, because I said in one of my posts earlier, like, they manipulated words and played around with words way before I do. But I like words. I like looking at them. I see other... The minute I see Satan in this damn Santa, you got to go, Satan. I'm not welcoming you in my house, not ever again. Not through trickery, not through none of it. God gave me a free will. Hell, if I choose not to serve God, what the hell make you think I'm gonna serve you? But see, you forcing yourself on me. The kingdom of heaven suffering violent. What? And the violent people taking it by force. Because they forcing the shit on us Christians. You sitting back taking it. I'm not taking it with you. Ah, that's what they mean. Don't be evenly yoked. Unevenly yoked. You damn right. It's a lot of us Christians unevenly yoked. In what we believe. In what God is showing us. How much of our faith, because we're always given a measure of it, that we choose to use. So even us, we're unevenly yoked. Because we'd rather have all these other get-togethers, but, oh, let's study the Word. We'd rather have all these other stuff going on. See, you're not going to have me blind. The blind leading the blind. You're not going to have me religiously deprived. You're not. Yeah, I said religiously, because in certain places you can say religiously deprived of God. Like, you're not going to have me deprived of a relationship with Him. You're not going to deprive me of trying. You know how many people believe in the Christian faith trying to get to heaven right now may not make it? May not make it. And even in knowing Christianity and what that religion is about, it's simple. It's not a hard thing to do. But then when you got it on people who come from slavery who it's not meant for, it becomes hard to do. I've been on both sides of the fence. Christianity worked for me most of my life. Hope and prayer, faith, that works. But now when you put hope, prayer, and faith to Yahweh, Yeshua, Holy Ghost, Holy Spirit, they call them Spirit in the Old Testament. God called them Holy Ghost in the New Testament, in the Old Testament. They call them Holy Spirit in the New Testament, mainly. Them old folks, them old storefront churches dealt with the Holy Ghost. The Holy Ghost had a lot more power, a lot more than I see the Holy Spirit in most churches. So much you gotta run around, catch the good. Nah, I read where people lay hands on people and the Holy Spirit is given. I read where God poured his Spirit out on all flesh is given. I read where Jesus said, I must leave so that I can send you a comforter. It's given. You don't catch this Holy Ghost through you. So, I can go there, I can do it, but God tells me you don't have to do all that to get what you want from God. That's just so much. So a lot of people is unevenly yoked when it comes with Christianity in and of itself. So I'm just here trying to show you, Christians, we have a God. We have faith. We have a Christ. He been mocked. He been, Bible said, byword, proverb, and mocked all of the, yeah, the Bible talks about people being bywords, proverbs, and mocks, mockery. I think they did that to Jesus, to Christ. So you can do what you want to do to Zeus' twin brother, Jesus. I wouldn't care. I ain't going to say Jesus is fake because he is Christ. But take that name Jesus off of there. If you can't say nothing, just say the anointed one of God. If you ain't sure, anointed one of Yahweh. I don't know. But when you keep that Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Yeah. They said Jesus, God is no respecter of persons, right? So Jesus would be working for us all according to our faith and according to what we believe. How much we interact with him, how much we read. Brings me to this. If we all getting it from the pastor and say none of us is reading our Bibles, say none of us is studying at home, oh hell, we going to hell. We going to hell. We just getting it from our pastors. Because look at the wider body of church. Pastors are part of the problem. Church is in the way, in the state of mind that it is in. I don't got time for nobody be trying to send me to hell because they don't want to go admit, oh man, I've been doing it wrong. Oh man, this does make sense. Oh man, the Romans. But they got to make it to the Vatican to sit with the Pope. You can probably do that any given day when it comes to your religion and your relationship with Yahweh. Well, everybody ain't supposed to be this one melting pot. You got people out here that don't like God, and we keep mixing and mingling with these people like they really like God and they don't. And they seduce you and suck you in. Oh, baby Jesus, he poor baby. Thank God for Jesus. We ain't po' though, huh? But yeah, because you stole. You not only stole the religion from the people. You went through and stole their gold and silver, too. You stole their land. You stole their birthrights. You stole their royalty, their relationship with God to rule as kings and queens in the earth. You stole a lot from a lot of people. And this world don't expect you. Oh, we did wrong. We sorry. Here go the Vatican. Here go everything. Well, what's going to happen is, until Jesus come, y'all going to keep molesting them little boys over there. Y'all going to keep letting the bishops get away with it. And what goes on in the Catholic Church, Roman Church, oh, you Christian folks, you just ride right along with what that nasty ass shit. You just go along with it. You just go along with all that nasty stuff in the church. But this is what the Book of Maccabees Second Maccabees chapter 6 says about their church and what